Ja. 10, 9, Ignition Sequence starts. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Lift off. Welcome to the Alien Probe Podcast. It is Saturday, February 10th, 2024. I'm Doug. And here today, again, is Edwin Trowell. This is the second time Edwin's been on. Hi, Edwin. How are you doing?
I'm doing fine. No, thanks very much. I'm doing all good.
I love that English. Well, it's not an English accent, is it? Where are you from?
You're from? I'm from Scotland, but I was brought up in England.
Yeah.
That's interesting. That in the middle of England, that's the kind of accent I've got. Like Yorkshire.
Yeah. And then there's some things we didn't... This is our second time chatting. And some things we didn't really cover on the first episode that I wanted to kind of cover. And you sent me a narrative. Edwin sent me his narrative. It's 33 pages. I'm not going to show everybody all the pages. Edwin is going to make a coffee table book. He's got Edwin. You can't see this on your screen, but I've got one of your images up right now. I want to bring up some of the other images in a second. But Edwin is from your narrative. You're a starseed. Tell us a little bit about how you got to Earth, Edwin.
Well, I have a memory before I was born of actually travelling through the stars. And I sort of like, I woke up and I was in this craft, I was heading toward her, and they woke me up. They said, "This is where you're going." And next thing I know, I started hurtling down the earth and I was born, natural. That's all I know.
Yeah.
All I realized, there were millions of stars around me.
So you got to Earth, I mean, you just were, according to your story, you were brought by the beings. And then you were brought into Earth. You have a twin brother. You didn't say what happened. Is your twin brother still around?
Yes, I have a twin brother, yes.
Is he live by you?
He lives about 100 miles away.
Yeah.
150 miles away.
So you guys, you're not both the starseed though, right? Have you talked to your brother about this?
No. I haven't really. I've kept him in the hole. Pretty much.
You can do it, Edwin.
He has no recollection of me, like, you know, going through the stars. So I don't say nothing, John.
Yeah.
I haven't told many people, actually. You know, I've only told one or two.
Yeah. So don't tell a lot of people about this?
No, I think I've only known about, maybe 3 or 4 people in my life.
Well, you're on social media now. You're on Facebook? You tell people? You tell your story on Facebook?
I know one and no one Facebook, yes.
So you're brought to Earth, and then your story goes on. You're kind of bullied as a kid in school. They pick on kids pick on you?
No, well, you know, growing up, you know.
Yeah, and you worked for, and then you worked for a, I think I had to decipher this because it's not the same as we do here in lovely United States. Is it a garbage truck that you drove where you picked the guy up?
I've driven all vehicles in, you know, garbage trucks and lorries and all kinds of vehicles.
Yeah. It's kind of funny. I'm familiar a little bit about the train. I don't. One of my kids played with Thomas the Train. I don't know if you ever heard of that.
When I was young, I had a milk float, a wagon with milk urn on. But anyway,
Yeah.
not with her, not at all. My mum bought me a little wagon, a little lorry.
Not a
Little
lorry. Your lorry is a truck, right? That's just a truck.
truck, truck.
And you'd pick up things. So then you wandered into a store one day, and you saw you don't generally look at jewelry and things. You were looking at something else. And tell us about what
What?
you found there.
Well, I went into what we call a charity shop, but it's a thrift shop that you have in America. You buy things from a charity thrift shop. And when I went in, I seen this pendant. I've actually got it with me now. I'll show you on the camera.
I've got it on the screen too.
Can I show it? Yeah. Only I might shake a minute. Maybe back if hang on a minute now. Just one moment. I bought this.
Wow. Okay, lift it up a little higher because you're not a, lift it up higher, higher, higher. Keep going. Now I see. Very nice. Yeah, I thought you
Yeah.
got rid of that. Didn't you sell it? Didn't you sell it to something?
No, I didn't know. I sent. Let me just run it back. I sent half of it to the mole farm in Mississippi, and then the other half. And they got it sent back after I got the analysis. Sorry, my arm shaking a bit.
Right.
And then they sent it me back. They said it was no match for any earth metal, and it was maybe 4 or 5 thousand years old, Egyptian. Anyway, I sent a few samples out throughout the world, and I never got any samples back or analysis. And I cut it in half to send it to Mole Farm. Anyway, I sent the half over to a laboratory in New York. And they never sent it back to me, all the analysis. So,
Okay, so that's three between 3 and 5,000 years old, I guess, huh? So that's pretty valuable, right?
that's what Mole Farm said. Now, up to then, Dom, hundreds of people, UFO people, and ordinary people, just people that don't follow, they just said it was rubbish. So I sent it to Mole Farm, thinking it was just rubbish, or an antiquity, or something like that, because there were no markings on it. It's very old. As you see, there's quite a lot of pictures. I've got over 5,000 pictures. And they sent it back and said there were no marks for any earth metals. And what it was done, it was solid gold with a platinum covering. And then it had like diamonds on top, but then diamonds have been crushed. And I kept getting a very high reading for diamonds. I don't understand why. Anyway, I spoke to a lot of people and they just said it was rubbish. But anyway, when I got the message that there was no match for any metal, or metal, base metals, they said it was solid gold and platinum, which I believe would have happened when we had the first supernova.
So,
That's right.
you thought it was from, I don't know, I can't, I did some research of it, of the images, and the name you gave me is a little different than what I found, when I researched it. It's called the Adinkras, civilization. It's kind of, or a people. I mean, and they're from Africa, though. You were talking about Egypt.
Oh yeah, that was the first one I got back in the ancient Africa.
Yeah, so these images, and I've got the images up of the a nice picture of, the pendant itself. I think it's a pendant. It's like four squares and a
That's
little
right.
squiggle and a little like comma. Looks like a comma, on.
That's right. In the common dome, that's where I found the picture on the little alien.
Yeah.
Right. And in the four knots, that is the four pyramids of Giza.
And that's what I'm having a little bit of trouble figuring out. In the brown pendant, you put that under the microscope and without cutting it up, and you saw something moving. You saw some small microscopic creatures.
Yes, I did have pictures, but I deleted them. I mean, my old camera, my old mobile phone, cell phone, I dropped it and smashed it, and I tried to transfer all the pictures over, but they didn't all come over. But I have some pictures of, what, just not a video, but pictures of strange little white creature things. I don't know what they are.
Yeah, they're.
I might have sent you one or two pictures. I've got that many,
Yeah, it well that and that's what I got from the story that you and then you cut it open. Now, what did you cut open to expose the you hacksawed it or you sawed it with something and it had
I
little
did.
pieces. What did you cut? What was the item that you cut apart?
It was a pendant because
Another
when
pendant?
not the same one,
Yeah.
I cut that one, the square one, in half. They said only send him one half because he might not get it back. So I sent half the move one. And then they did the analysis and then
Right.
they sent it.
And you sent a MUFON in America?
Yes, move on in America, yes. I've got the certificate number if you'd like to have a look.
What did they say was the material?
The material was no match for any earth metals, and that it was solid gold with a platinum covering that had been pounded many thousands of times, many thousands of layers. Layer after layer, been pounded many, many times. Not made in the traditional way.
Right.
And they said that there were no match for any other earth metal, platinum and gold and diamond. But
Wow.
they didn't, it was the XRF machine that they used.
Did they send the piece back to you?
They did send it back to me down, yes.
Oh, wow, I'm surprised.
I know that. They wouldn't send it back, but they did. Anyway, I got it back, no. And then I sent it to a lab in Australia. Sorry, I'm taking a bit of money back.
Yeah.
They sent the, then I sent it to New York lab, and I never got it back.
Good. So we've seen, so you cut it apart and you looked at it under a microscope and you saw, this is something we didn't get into a great deal during the last episode. And you saw some
Oh.
creatures that they're little white creatures. I mean, do they look like, your typical aliens? I mean, this is what, when I bring this up to a couple of
What?
people, I mean, they at first they say, "Wow, that's insane," but then they think about it and it's like, why can't aliens be microscopic? I mean, or some of them.
What it is done, when you look at the universe, it's vast. But also, when I look at this pendant, I see a universe that's the same universe, but microscopic. Now, when I looked at the little white creatures that first arrived, that I first saw 3 or 4 years ago, they were all. I've got a photo of it, so I'll be able to send it to you shortly. Now, inside these little spiky insect things, I don't know what they were. There was like a machine, like a spacecraft. So I kept looking at it and trying to blow it up and see how much detail I can get. Anyway, a friend of mine on the internet, on the UFO channels, said that it was the first time he'd ever seen anything like that, and they'd been looking for over 20, 25 years.
Is the pendant, is the pendant maybe their universe or their, I have to fix this microphone. Is that their universe, do you think? Is that what we're seeing?
What I can make of it, there is a large universe that we see now, but there's also a very microscopic universe that is identical. Now, when I studied a video that I put a lot of things together, first I put the metal on a magnetic field, and it seemed to work. Anyway, after that, I got a video back on, and it actually went like a paradox in time. I can see my clock in the living room going forwards and backwards at the same time. I know that's hard to believe, but I am some sort of time travel. Anyway, I was there 48 minutes, and I lost 2 hours and 19 minutes of time.
You don't have the video anymore, I guess, right?
That's the video I lost when I'm at my small. I've been trying to get hold of it, and if I don't find it, I will show it to you.
What did you film it on?
I filmed it on my previous camera phone.
It was on your camera phone.
Connected to the computer, no. I've got it connected to the computer with a cable.
So you took thousands or hundreds of, I should say, hundreds of pictures of this thing. And
5,000 pictures I've got of things that are happening. And also nearly 500 videos, 1 minute videos.
And you lost all of them?
No, I've still got all of them. I lost the early ones. But I've got some stills, and I'll send them to you.
They sent me the pictures, but I didn't get any videos of the...
I've been trying, I really haven't.
Well, I saw one where it looked like a white splotch. Kind of a white splotch, and it... Yeah, it looked like it could be something. It was kind of hard for me to make out, but it was moving. But looked kind of big on the. But I mean, are these things organized like they're a tiny civilization building? They were building something, right? They were trying to repair where you cut, or what were they doing?
Well, what they are, it's like a microscopic civilization, but also. They are massively advanced. They're at least Cardassians, level 3. Maybe no level 3. And what I've observed, is that in these videos, they've built vast cities in the space of a few, just an hour or so. And it's fascinating to watch, but a little bit frightening.
Yeah, that would be weird. Do they have cars and stuff?
No,
airplanes. You know, are they advanced?
What I saw was a normal civilization like we have: cars, trucks, buses. But I've also seen the other side: their advancements. That are way, way beyond. I once seen up the news 1 million spacecraft vehicles within I would say 20 minutes. It was fascinating.
Wow.
They're storing all these vehicles, spacecraft vehicles, in a larger vehicle, a bit like the one you sent me, though. That's why I'm fascinated by the picture you sent me is very,
Yeah.
very, very interesting.
And they had a little explosion on the table, you said, a little like light beam, and the table moved, and
Yeah, that's what I'm frightened of.
yeah.
You see, at first I'm observing them. I thought, are they going to blow up? They look pretty advanced. Anyway, I was playing my music, and I was observing a very tiny microscopic creature, magnification 2000. And there was a loud bang, and my table that I was leaning on lifted off the air, and lifted me with it. And I thought, this tiny microscopic creature has tremendous power. I don't know why that, it frightened the life out of me. I don't know what happened, but anyway, that's what happened. So after that, I gave up looking at it for a week or two, because I was a bit frightened of it, because I didn't know what was going to happen next. But it seemed to have tremendous power, to throw me off the table.
Your wife seen these?
My wife's only seen one or two little things, but all she sees mainly is flashing lights. She has seen one or two little things, but she doesn't care to look at it. I'm always looking down the microscope with my camera connected to it, seeing what there is.
Right.
And I sent you one or two videos that hopefully I've sent a lot on Facebook.
And you've seen these to, you sent these to scientists, any scientists or anything like that? Take it to any universities or try to communicate with any of them?
Have no guess. I'm trying to communicate with just about everybody. Now, my friend, who had a podcast station, was the last. Quite famous, I suppose. He said that what I'm observing, because I didn't know what I was looking at, is computerized machines that are autonomous and also cognitive connection to the human brain.
Yeah.
That's why, we can observe what I'm looking at. Now, I have got lots of videos, as I explained earlier, but I'm trying to get them over to you as soon as possible. Now, he did say that I was the only one. I've been looking for this for over 25, 30 years, and that I was the only one that had this kind of connection. Interface connection, they said, cognitive, if that's the
Yeah.
right word.
Interesting. Now, it yeah, so you're having in trouble getting anybody to believe you
Yes,
to
no, no.
investigate this from a further scientific viewpoint.
That's
I
right, that's
mean.
right. Now, what they say to me, though, is that I have a film studio and I'm doing all this to try and. I'm trying to the lie, tell the truth. And they say that I have a film studio. I don't have any of these things. I sent you a photograph of my little single room, and I've got a microscope and a mobile camera connected to the microscope.
Yeah.
Did you see those pictures, Dom?
But nobody, you're having trouble getting anybody to buy into your story, I'm taking it, because
Not many, but there are hundreds of people. There are loads of There's a lot of rain here now and a lot in the wind to me only.
Yeah.
But I don't know who they are. There's a lot of these places in America, radio stations, that say, come and join our radio station and explain what you're talking about. Well, I'm not a scientist, you know, so... And you're the only one that's let me on the podcast.
I saw some of the communication that you shared with some Facebook people. They don't really... They're not believing what's going on here, it looks like.
They say, it's all make believe, and I've produced it all myself, which I've got no... I can't even get my computer to work when I'm getting the graphics card. Never mind make a film studio of something. I mean, I've no reason to lie, you know. I mean, I'm 70 years old. You know, these things have happened, and I don't know why. But anyway, I didn't know any of this. They just, when I first got the metal, they just said it was rubbish. And that's what I believe. But since I've seen all this information that comes through, it's a bit frightening now, I don't know what to make of it.
Now, you also stated that you had some time dilation issues about...
That's correct. I had a time dilation, like a paradox, that I lost 2 hours 19 minutes when I went away 44 minutes.
That's interesting.
Does that make sense?
No one else has experienced this with you?
Nobody else. But apart from that, my wife did see some flashing lights, but I tend not to involve my wife because she's not right sure what it is. All I can produce are the videos and the pictures. Whether people believe it or not, or call me a liar, or call me names, that's entirely up to them, but I've no reason to lie about any such. I've got nothing to gain, you know, if you know what I mean, though.
Yeah. You also stated that they moved very slowly, so slowly that you left them sitting, and then you had to look at it the next day to see where they moved from one point to the next.
That's correct, Don. Now, what I'm thinking there is that there could be a possibility that they're moving within a quantum field effect. That when you don't look at them, they move. But when you do look at them, they stop, you know, they stand still. Now, that's very similar to the quantum field effect, quantum dot. Would you not agree or disagree?
Yeah. What happens next, Edwin? You're still having... I mean, it's too bad they can't... You can't get someone, a young person or something, to get involved that is eager and interested in something unusual like this.
The person I got right in the beginning, I don't want to mention his name, is from Texas. He was a young person, and he was telling me what was going on, because me being an elderly person, I didn't know what was going on. I was still scared. But I noticed, you know, I was sat there one night, and I noticed this bending glowing. I put it on a magnet, because I tried to shine it up, but it wouldn't shine up with anything. Anyway, it started glowing, so I started to investigate. And this gap came back to me and said that this is what's happening. So I started to follow it through.
Is that you beeping or me?
Sorry a minute. Hold on a minute. Sorry a minute. No. Yeah, sorry, it's my phone. It's my medication for my partner. It's all right. Yes. Any more questions, Don? I mean, I can answer any questions.
Did you spend any time in the military?
No time in the military, Don. No. Not at all.
You didn't get drafted. You didn't get drafted or anything.
Oh, I wasn't old enough to get drafted, Don.
Oh, that's fine. Right. Yeah, you're not too much. Well, you're a little bit older than me, but yeah, I was. We had the Vietnam War. Because you guys weren't involved too much in the Vietnam War, were you?
We weren't, no, and I was still young anyway. That was 1967. I'd only be about 11, 12, 13.
You pay attention to the. We'll go off topic a little bit with this.
Right.
About politics. You pay attention to any American politics?
Not really, apart from the. I don't want to get political, obviously. I like Biden, you know, he seems more. I'm a bit frightened. Well, I'm a bit frightened of Trump because he's a bit controversial. You know. Anyway, I won't say any more about that.
Yeah, it's a little odd. Things are a little weird going on out there, Edwin. I don't know. Tucker Carlson interviewed Vladimir Putin. If you ever get a chance to watch that, it was good.
No, I haven't watched it a lot. But we're just saying that he was giving it over his whole point of view, which was probably very similar to other world leaders that want to rule the world. Well, I don't know. But I don't follow a bit of politics, but not much.
You don't? You guys are a little closer to the Ukraine than we are. Are you concerned about any of that going sideways?
I am because it's on it's Europe, isn't it, Doug? You know, if us and the Allies and America, of course, the all the superpowers, we don't prevent them, they'll be over, possibly.
Yeah, I'm always interested in the viewpoint of people from other countries about America.
Yeah, all right. Well, we're glad you're still a superpower, but it's a bit frightening, but you know, to see a superpower because a superpower is not enormous power.
Yeah. You know? Do they have MUFON there in your by where you live?
Well, as far as I know, I didn't know all this, you see. As far as I know, the MUFON all over the world, you know, in the UK as well. But yeah. I never sent it to MUFON. A friend of mine said send it to a museum, which I was going to. But then, when I put the metal on a magnet, it started glowing, so I never sent it to the museum. I started to investigate. I'm curious that way. You know,
well, they're. We don't know if these things are alien. That's the were they.
Oh no,
they're not a spacecraft. They're they're everything. But as far as what might be considered extraterrestrial, but not necessarily. We don't know if extraterrestrials have just these things might have always been here.
Yeah. Well, what I can say is that they've always been here. Now. I did send you a photograph of the metal edge on, and it had all these dots on. Well, I see a photograph just recently on Facebook. One of the other, organizers. And they said that they found some dots on the stone over a million years old. Now those dots match the same dots on the metal. On the metal, there are hundreds, if not thousands, of maps and drawings and pictures and buildings and all sorts of things mapping out things around the world. It's incredible.
Yeah.
I didn't see any drawings or maps. MUFON did. They went under a very powerful microscope.
Well, they didn't find any. Did you let them know when they did the examination of the metal that you felt that there is a civilization living inside this metal?
No, I didn't. Nothing happened. No, I didn't know then. No,
you didn't know that then.
I didn't know then. It was only when they sent the metal back to me that I started noticing things. The first thing I noticed about what the possibility, it started to try and heal itself. I put the two bits of metal together, and it in a magnetic magnet, and it tried to heal. Now, after that, I I mean, looking at a picture of the thing, they've had a little arm that came out on the metal. I don't know what it was. It was very strange. It was very small. Anyway, that went back in, and I haven't painted it off.
Have you looked at this lately through the microscope? Is it still happening?
It's still happening. Yes. Yes.
Have you considered getting some better videoing equipment, and you know, really to be video and micro? You know, you can video things with special equipment through microscopes, or have, you know, enlist you know, someone.
I have no such equipment, or no expertise. All I have is a camera, a mobile phone, and a wire connected to the microscope, which is 2,000 magnification, and I work it all up there.
Yeah.
I don't have no expertise on film. I mean, if I could get hold of somebody who had that kind of expertise, I would gladly let them film all this. It's fascinating. But I have no expertise on such things.
Well, hopefully somebody...
I can't afford the equipment either.
Hopefully...
probably lost a lot of money, though.
Hopefully somebody who watches the show here will, you know, be able to help you. I mean, I wish I could.
I know welcome it, Norm, that anybody with any expertise, please come forward.
You know, or get you on to... a higher level podcast or show that can, you know, get some assistance for you to get actually video these properly. I wish you were in America.
We don't have that kind of following here. It's all in America.
Yeah,
I need to get onto the people that know these things and then understand what's going on. It's quite fascinating. It's taught me a lot about what I know, what, you know, the universe and microscopy. But a lot of people say to me, without even looking at the material, and I have all the time, you know, thousands of pictures and hundreds of videos, just very short videos, 1 or 2 minutes. I just wish I could get somebody with expertise knowledge, like, you actually look into it. No, I've been trying for the last 3 or 4 years, but the only response I've had up to now, Doug, has been your very helpful help.
I interviewed Colin, I don't know if you've heard of him, he's Colin Sanders, he's in the UK. I did an interview, he's seen triangular UFOs, and their phenomena, you know, how they morph into like different shapes, I think is his thing.
Yes, that's right. Yeah.
Yeah.
The kind of craft that I see on this on the metal light is the whole different shapes, many, many different shapes, including the triangle.
Yeah. So there's a lot of sightings over there in the UK.
Yes, I've had 3 or 4 sightings myself.
Yeah, you had something flying around. They were battling in outside your window.
UFOs? Yeah, that was right. I've got the video. Did you manage to?
I wasn't able to get the battle video out of you.
Well, I don't have the battle video. I didn't look out the window. I was scared. I really was. I was in bed with a sore leg, and I was humped up with and I had the fan on. The next thing I know, all hell broke loose. Anyway, I stayed where I was. I started to film it, which I did with my mobile camera. I mean, it would have been, and all these bright lights started coming to the window. I had the blind shut, but it was a sunny day. And my friend said to me, oh, it's only cars going past. Well, to be quite honest, if that's a car going past, with, you know, with reflection. You know, I've lived at my house for nearly 40 years and never seen anything like that.
Yeah.
Something actually came through and landed on the bay, and it frightened the life out of me and then disappeared. Now, I don't know what it was, but I hope it don't come back. I was terrified.
Did it go in the water?
Did it go what?
Did it go in the water in the bay? Did you say the bay? Where did you see it?
Oh, no, the bed. The bed. I was on the bed, lying on the bed.
Oh.
With the saw. I had the saw legs on. I'll send you the video, hopefully. You might be able to see it.
Yeah, any UFO video I'd like to see.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Did you see one of the little small alien with the big eyes? I sent you a picture.
Yeah. Yeah, it's an interesting image.
I don't know where that's from. I've no idea what it is. It just came through.
Let me see if I can bring that one up.
Bring that one up. Maybe some of your viewers might know what it is.
It's a... Yeah, it looks like just like a bulbous head.
Yeah, that's right. Yes, I haven't a clue what it is. I've no idea where it came from. It frightened a lot. I didn't watch it too much because it frightened me a bit. Huh. I need some experts that know what's going on, you know, with this metal.
Huh. That's interesting. Yeah, it's a lot of interesting information, Edwin. I appreciate it. Appreciate you coming on the show.
Well, that's it. You know, I mean, I've got nothing to hide, mate. I mean, ask me anything you like. I mean, I would like to say, Doug, that I'm a Christian being a person. I believe in God. And I believe in the creation of the universe created by God and Jesus Christ. I just want to make that clear that I don't follow any entities or anything like that. But I am a strong, you know, strong faith of Jesus Christ, my Savior. So I don't follow anything like that. The universe is vast. In the valves, you know, when the latest technology, they're finding out a lot about the universe that's happening now, you know, it's a lot older, and what have you, you know. But I am a Christian, and I will not renounce my faith for anything. So that's what I am doing, you know. I want to be completely honest. You know, I don't know why I remember traveling to other stars, but I just know it just happened. But what I'm looking for, is actually somebody with a level of expertise in video and knowledge of what's actually happening, or what is not happening. You know, I mean, if you get an expert on that, or experts that you may know over in America, that say it's all a load of rubbish, then it's just a load of rubbish. But nobody has said that to me, though. Nobody will say that. They won't question my pictures or videos, apart from they just say it's rubbish. But then they don't go away, they come back later on and say, well, I don't think it's rubbish, I think it's real. I mean, what can I say, though? If there's anybody there that can help with the verification of what I'm actually doing on the metal, that would be interesting. And I really don't mind if it's discredited by any expert. I just want to know what's actually happening. You know, I know
you won't miss me. Well, Edwin, hopefully somebody will pop up that we can send your way to kind of invest, to do a further invest. I think you need some more powerful equipment there and videography equipment.
Yeah, I don't have any such thing. These things cost a lot of money and I have no expert needs. A lot of people say, hey, I'm a film studio like Hollywood, but I don't have anything like that, Doug.
Yeah, because there is a lot of equipment. Well, not a lot. There is equipment out there that, you know, that could definitely bring this to be a great story, It is a great story. It's one I haven't, it's when I tell people about this, it's one that people haven't ever really considered when they talk about aliens. We don't know if they're aliens. We don't know if they've just been here. We don't know where they're
Well,
from.
it's microscopic, and all I can think then is that there's an alpha universe and there's a minute in the universe at microscopic level. But what's happening in this inner universe is identical to the outside universe, vast universe that we've seen.
Yeah. All right, sir. Well, we're going to wrap it up. Is there anything you'd like to add before we sign off?
Well, I'd like to say one thing. I hope you'll invite me on again. I am desperately asking for help with any with any knowledge help that may come on the old program, on the old Labs Nation dog, and try and assist me in what I'm actually looking at, and also the verify, the false or true, what's actually on the videos and the pictures. Now, as far as I'm aware, there have been some picture video people that say that what I'm showing is not being tampered with. It is, 100% accurate. That's all I know.
Okay. Thank you very much. We're going to wrap it up. Thanks for
Right.
listening to the latest episode of the Alien Probe Podcast. We welcome comments, questions, or requests to alienprobepodcast@gmail.com. Visit us on Facebook. Check out our website, alienprobe.net, Twitter and Instagram at alienprobepod, YouTube and Ramble. Like and subscribe. Thank you, Edwin Trowell. We appreciate your story. And we hope to get you some help out there to help bring this thing to light.
Well, thank you very much, Doug. You're the only one that's listening to me at the moment. And hopefully, we'll come back on your podcast and get some expertise that can verify or discredit what's actually happening here, Doug. So I look forward to seeing you again shortly when you'll make the time, and I'll speak to you later. Best of luck to everybody in America.
Okay, thanks for coming on, Edwin. We'll see you next time.
Okay, Doug, I'll be in contact. Speak to you later. Bye.
All right, watch the skies.